You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. A long time forgotten, dreams are just filled by the way. Good life he promised, and what she's lived in the day. She never complained of the good times and the bad things he's done.
Came in here today. They were working in the kitchen. Jane and Becky were also helping out. And, you know, we're just bringing the soda in. I just stayed out of the kitchen. All right, making a difference and leaving a mark. August 1979, Roxy started the petroleum distribution industry. In October of 96, she became burn service coordinator at her office in Watertown. In August of 2000, our company needed me to fill out another role with the company, so I left as Watertown branch manager, and Eric Scott took charge as service manager, and Roxy took charge as branch manager. Many times we view awards as recognition of the job well done. They also become new benchmarks for others to follow. Many times we view awards, when awards are presented by great leaders, they have that extra pride that go with them. Boyd Foster presented Roxy with the Burnham Service Employee Award in 1996. John Hamilton presented Roxy with the EBITDA Award for 2006 and again in 2007. Keith Risley welcomed Roxy into the President's Club for both 2011 and 2012. Friday, January 2nd, 1998. Jane Miller sent me a message in our old SDS system. Said, Happy New Year. Graded 98. A week later, we were put to the test. Ice Storm 98. Y'all remember that? On Thursday, January 8th, approximately 100,000 Niagara Mohawk customers were without electricity. The utility predicted it would take 5 or 6 days to restore power, but it was more than 3 weeks before the last 100 had their lights restored power. Jefferson County, St. Lawrence, Northern Lewis, Franklin, Clinton, and Essex counties were all but paralyzed. States of emergency were declared. Emergency shelters opened. Travel bans were declared. Both ends of our road on Gillette Road were blocked just enough that we could not get our trucks out for deliveries. Customers began arriving looking for kerosene. By 10 a.m., we were dispensing Caro into customers' containers off our truck using an adapter and a station outlet. Customers were lined up all the way to the road waiting for their kerosene. Roxy took care of all the activities inside the office while I picked up a generator from the Emergency Operations Corps to run our plant. Roxy was taking service calls from customers with no heat and dispatching our techs, at that time including Eric Scott, even Stacy Sullivan. Techs would get there and often find no power or no furnace, underwater. Roxy quickly adapted to our normal questions to get better detail of the nature of the call. Classics like, do you have power? And has your furnace been underwater? Come to mind. Our plant went 18 days without power, and Roxy was there every day. Last year was a challenging year for everyone. Drivers and techs working countless hours in chest-deep snow, digging for tanks and fills. Propane was difficult to get for everyone in the industry, yet Roxy found a way to keep the trucks on the road and product to deliver. Roxy made it work. These are just samples of the dedication that she has in her work. Roxy. You know, another 146 days, and you could hit 13,000? And you could hit 13,000 times around the sun in this business. You're welcome to stay with us another 146 days. Making a difference, leaving a mark.
On behalf of the staff and all your peeps at Griffith, here's a little gift for you.
We hope you remember one time when I was talking on the phone to a customer and Brett put a snowball down my neck. There's a lot of people here that I share a lot of memories with and appreciate you coming out.
No one puts in the kind of hours the love, the devotion of her family, and I know that that is stood by her for all these years, and she's the unsung hero in the background that put up with her movements all night, or things haven't gone especially right, and I know that the rest of her family has gone without having her for a number of winters, so in the last 18 years she's been with the company. The best way to describe Roxy is the way she treats the customers. And whether it's an internal customer or an external customer, she treats the customers with compassion, caring, thoughts, which is what makes her such a special person. And I'm sure everyone in this room has lots of funny Roxy stories. I don't have that many funny Roxy stories, although I have gotten to go to St. Thomas with her, and so I have a few that I'll share. But my first experience with Roxy was about, I think, 5 years ago. And I was up for a clean-up spruce-up tour, and I had heard all these stories about what a clean-up spruce-up tour was with Roxy. You'd walk in there, and the plant would be, you know, exceptionally maintained, and everything would be planted, and there would be flowers out there, and the team was all bright. But the one thing that they told me was come hungry, because when you get to the plant, there's going to be food and everything. And so I walk in, and I didn't know she was a painter. Now I know why the plant looks the way it does. But there was a table full of pies. And so the one thing I've taken away from Roxy was that there was always pies. And while she ran an exceptional plant, the bribery to the judges for the spruce up cleanup was the best of anywhere that it was. So I want to talk about the commitment to the community and the experience that I've had. The President's Club, when we give that award, we give it out for exceptional customer service. And Roxanne was a two-time winner of a three-year program, so we're only in the 3 years of the program, and Roxanne was a President's Club winner for two of those. The first year that she went to the Bahamas, and then last year to St. Thomas. And Roxanne, on those trips, proved that there's another side of her. The adventurous side. So the first year we saw Roxanne out swimming with the dolphins.
And for hours.
For hours and hours and hours. And on top of that, she made many visits to the dark and stormy. So I wasn't quite there for the dark and stormy, but I'll leave her to that. There. Lastly, I need to just talk for a minute about Roxanne's commitment to her team. You know, it's remarkable in this industry when I look up here at the probably 20 or 25 years from Agway all the way through Griffith, many different owners, to what we're having here. But what always comes back to me every time I walk into the plant is the commitment that she has to the team and the commitment that the team has to her. And for a plant manager, a service manager, you really understand the individual, the leadership by the people that are around her and the way they came to her. So on behalf of the company, myself, your employees, thank you very much. Thank We're you. Going to miss you and have a great retirement. Ed, I know you're not going to see much of her, she'll be up in the paint studio, but enjoy the time of not having to have her come home grumpy.
Thank you.